are we talking about today? We are going to talk about the very controversial topic. And yeah, that is very controversial because people have agreed and disagreed with this thing that I'm going to talk about. And it's like 50-50. Like, people have disagreed with the thing and people have agreed with the thing. There are many dermatologists that have agreed with the topic that I'm going to talk about. And there are many dermatologists that totally disagree with that. So today I'm going to talk about facial hair shaving and I'm going to show how I shave my hair. Before anybody comes for me, let me tell you that shaving is a very, very subjective topic or an issue. I like to shave my facial hair once or twice a month because I'm comfortable with that, but that doesn't mean that I am not comfortable with my facial hair. I am totally comfortable. I can go without shaving my face for months and then suddenly I get that urge of getting rid of the facial hair, and I will tell you later on because why I shave my facial hair. Similarly, you can see I do have a lot of body hair and I just don't think that it is necessary to shave it off because it doesn't cause any problem. But then my facial hair, because of my facial hair, I tend to get acne. Like, I don't really get acne, I get rashes. That is what I feel. And even before I started shaving my face with a razor, I once went to the doctor for some issues and then I did ask him that is shaving harmful for the skin. He said, no, it is not. If you cannot wax your face or if you're allergic to waxing, then you can opt for shaving your face with a razor, and girls like me who are allergic to waxing can opt for shaving their facial hair. Well, shaving is a process of exfoliating your skin and getting rid of the dead skin cells. Even after we scrub our face, there is this layer called peach fuzz that accumulates all over our face, all over our skin, and by shaving our facial hair, we are also getting rid of the peach fuzz. And I really love the feel of the baby soft skin that I get after shaving. Well, I have heard that many people get rashes, and maybe because they are allergic to shaving. And yeah, every skin type is different and people can be allergic to certain things. And certain things or the similar things can work out for other people. So shaving my face with a razor really works out for me. Whereas waxing my face really does, even waxing any part of my body really doesn't work for me because I'm allergic to wax and I'm allergic to pressure. So the pull and the pressure applied while waxing doesn't really work for me. So it is a very, very convenient and easy way for me to get rid of hair. Now before you start shaving, let's burst a very common myth that has been going around for years now, that if you shave your face, you're going to get more hair. No, you're not going to get more hair if you're shaving your face. I have been shaving my face for 2 years now and I haven't experienced that thing, or it is not scientific because hair growth totally depends on hormones and genes. So if you have this hormone or gene where you usually get more hair, then you're naturally going to get intense hair growth. Like, yeah, intense hair growth, but it won't be because of shaving, but because it is what you have in your genes and hormones. So yeah, you don't get more hair growth after you shave. You don't. Second thing, if you are going to shave, either shave downwards or shave upwards. Don't go here and there, up and down, left and right, because that way you're going to get a very funky kind of a hair growth. Like, yeah, you need to decide. You just need to decide if you're going to shave upwards or downwards and follow the pattern. Thirdly, do not dry shave, because by dry shaving, you're going to irritate your skin, because while you're shaving, you need a very smooth and silky base for the razor to glide and for a clean shave. And if you're going to dry shave, you're going to irritate your skin, and that way you're going to get rashes. So avoid dry shaving. And fourthly, just remember that shaving your facial hair is not a permanent solution of getting rid of your hair, because you are not eradicating the hair all away from the root. The root hair is still there and you're going to get it back within a week or two, and that is why I shave twice a month, because I feel that after shaving my skin really feels good and it gets rid of all the germs, all the peach fuzz and all the gunk that way, and I tend to get less rashes. So now I'm going to shave and show you guys how I shave. For shaving, you really don't need to have very expensive razors. You can just get razors like this from Amazon, and they're just for 150 or 200 within that, or maybe 250, not more than that, and you get 3 in a pack. I got this razor from Amazon. They were in a pack of 3, and the brand that I use is called Tinkle. Well, I do not have a camera, I have a phone, so you might not see much of facial hair in my face, so I will insert a clip of my facial hair, and while I shave, I'm going to show you the close-up. So this is the razor that I'm going to use, it is from Tinkle, as I've already shown, and yeah, let's shave now. So now I'm going to apply my face wash, and because I was already thinking of shaving, I didn't apply any moisturizer, anything. I just applied eyeliner and lipstick. So here I am. Here I've applied face wash for the razor to glide properly. Now I'm going to shave off the hair and get rid of the hair. Shaving is a bit of a risky activity, so you really need to be very concentrated while you are doing the work, otherwise you can injure yourself. Move the razor in a slanted manner and do not apply much pressure while you're shaving, because that way you can give yourself an injury. I usually shave my sideburns, my mustache area, the area right around my chin, because that is where I tend to get hair more than any other part of my face. I don't usually shave my forehead because I don't really get that much hair in my forehead. If you guys can see that, with the hair, dirt and gunk is also coming out, and this is the reason why I prefer shaving, because it is a painless way to get rid of all the gunk and the peach fuzz. This is the part where I think I need most concentration, because this is the most uncomfortable area of my face, and I tend to have less control of how I'm going to shave this area, so I need much concentration for shaving my sideburns, otherwise I can cut myself and I can get a really bad injury, which I don't really want. Do not hurry or rush while you are shaving. Give yourself good amount of time to get rid of the hair. Do it slowly and with patience. Immediately after you are done with shaving your face, you need to apply toner all over your face, just like I'm doing. I'm using the Khadi's toner, and I'm going to once you shave your face, you wash your face off, then you apply toner, it is time for moisturizer. I'm using the Biotic moisturizer by Biotic. I love this brand. It's affordable and really good brand. Might as well just do a skincare review of Biotic. Always remember to apply whatever you are applying in your face to your neck as well. Now that I'm done applying moisturizer, toner and shaving my face, my skin feels so good. I mean, yeah, it feels like a baby skin. I really love the feel of freshly shaved face. Like, it feels so good. No dirt, no gunk, no dry and dead skin. I mean, it feels so fresh. I'll just show you guys a close-up of my skin right now. Now, it's time for me to take your leave. Bye-bye. I'll see you guys soon with another video. And if you guys want me to do any video of your choice, please comment down on the comment section and I'll do as you say. Also, please follow me on Instagram so that you can be a part of my social media family, because I do post a lot of posts there and I take your suggestions on what videos I should make. So please be a part of my Insta family. Bye-bye. And please like, share and subscribe my channel.